Campbell with right cure. It's the fans. This really kind of puts us off a step here as far as the flow of this program is concerned, and I apologize. Let me tell you that I'm sure, and we're going to try to get back, and we're going to follow this story to see exactly why he's been arrested, and hopefully get him back. You can see that Kevin Nash wants him back because we've got a world title.
Yeah, we all want him back, but you know what I was saying? Any idiot, any liar can press a charge. The police have to do their job. They have to react with a warrant. I wouldn't worry about it because with the way our judges are nowadays, criminals are back on the street before the paperwork's processed anyway. So.
Jerry Saturn is out here, and this is like someone punching you right in the gut, Larry. It's not the win right out of Goldberg getting arrested.
But for what?
For what? Can someone answer us?
As long as Bischoff's a statue out here, can we get Tenay to do something?
I don't know. Bischoff, you gotta have
Tenay run down the story.
Well, let me tell you this, Eric. You're not gonna add anything to this broadcast, okay? Just go ahead and sit here. Do on your pad. Do whatever you want to do. But this is not looking good. This is not looking good on your next review. I know we've got some people at Human Resources here who would back me up on it.
Just think, Eric, you could be a vice president. You could be president when they impeach Hogan.
Sorry, give me the laugh. Chris Jericho, along with Ralphus, the security director.
Oh, stop it.
And Perry Saturn, this one-on-one matchup. Well, you saw Hulk Hogan, Hollywood Hogan, come in. He was going to address the fans here, and he had a chuckle at the expense of Goldberg.
Yeah, he did have a chuckle, and if he thinks he's going to come in the Dome and get a lot of votes, I don't think he's got the right attitude.
Not by saying what he said to Goldberg. I mean, this is Goldberg's home. This is where he had so many great games, football games, and of course the scene of his, well, I guess if you think about the scene of his biggest win at the expense of Hollywood Hogan, maybe to understand, but politicians talk out of both sides of their mouth. Yeah. They love everybody.
Well,
right?
This is the town that Hollywood Hogan was disgraced in. See if he can try to save his face.
So we will keep on top of that story. And I can tell you this, we will keep on top of the story, even if it means cutting away from a match during the progress of a match here live. That's what we're dedicated to. That is obviously the most important story developing in 1999 in the four short days. And at first it was Ric Flair, and that Ric Flair and his son would be a tag team. The match booked for the event sold out on the 17th of January, live from Charleston, West Virginia, against Barry Windham and Curt Hennig.
You know, and I got to almost agree with the Nature Boy. At first, his first reaction was, you know, my son's not ready yet. And Arn Anderson stood up for the boy, but really, I mean, he's still a young man. And Barry Windham and Curt Hennig are not young men. They're very experienced, tough guys.
Having a Ric Flair and his son together for the first time ever was our biggest story, except for you, Eric, being working with us, I should say.
Does that mean Harrison had to run around the office tomorrow with papers and deliver them to the secretary?
I haven't decided that, Eric, but we do need you in by 9 o'clock, okay, to our office.
In rush hour.
At 9 a.m. at our office, and you know where they are, and we'll have our regular announcer meeting there at 9 a.m. and look over this videotape. And I'm sure you will have not much to say there either about your performance here tonight. Nevertheless, that was the biggest breaking story, Flair and Flair together. But now the fact that Goldberg has been arrested, it's a true shocker, fans. I have no idea exactly what's going to happen. And I know there's going to be every effort made by promoters, by the lawyers here. Our lawyers are WCW lawyers to get him back in here in the Georgia Dome tonight to face Kevin Nash for the world title. That's what the fans want. That's what they're here for. Nothing like
hey, there's plenty of money around here. We'll get some lawyer. We'll give him out.
Yeah, there is plenty of money around here, and there's a lot of lawyers around here. I've talked to many of them tonight. I mean, we have a whole fleet of lawyers. You know, Eric, you remember a couple of those accountants you beat up on this program. They're here, too.
Yeah, you're a real popular man around here, Eric.
Yeah, they all want to talk to you tomorrow. Individual. Up and over.
In fact, Hudson knows an IRS guy wants to talk to Bischoff.
Up on top, watch out! Drop kick. And a good move that time by Jericho to put Perry Saturn down.
I tell you, serious and as down to earth as Saturn is, Jericho gets a little cocky right here, mocking something, but Jericho is very, very good, and he might have got Saturn into that typical mistake of underestimating somebody. Just because somebody is acting stupid doesn't mean they're thinking stupid.
Eric, did you hear anything through your headset about what the arrest, the charges were? Forget it.
They never tell me anything. Well, look at me.
So we don't know yet. And fans, we're going to, as we said, if it means breaking away during the course of this match or any match, we're going to hopefully, the next thing we see, Goldberg will be coming back here. And, of course, we still have quite a while. This is only the seventh segment of a 16-segment program, so we've got some time here. Meanwhile, in the ring now, Jericho, that arrogant cover, I mean, this has never gotten him a win, Larry, ever, and he continues to do things like this.
Well, I tell you, he's been in control of Saturn right here, but Jericho has been unable to beat the man. He's tried. Saturn is kicked out, and Jericho maintains control, but he lets Saturn on his feet. And that's not a smart thing to do.
And here he comes. Maybe spoke too soon that time.
Maybe not.
Saturn hooked him over the top. Spectacular move, Eric Bischoff, wouldn't you agree?
Good call, Eric.
Meanwhile, Saturn continues the offense.
Whoa.
Missed a spin wheel kick. Picked him up. Could be. He escaped from that DVD, that Death Valley driver, but did not escape from that move over the top. Into the mat, hit very hard.
And right now, he's paying a price tag for being cocky. Hold him down.
But could not keep him down.
That was too close.
Eric, would you like to do some play-by-play instead of some, would that make you feel better?
Do you want to say anything nice about Hogan?
Go ahead. Meanwhile, the referee, wrong place at the wrong time. Oh, my goodness. That was a full-fledged punt in a low blow. The Lion Salt connected.
That's not all that connected.
You're not kidding. Scott Dickinson, the referee.
He's ringing the bell.
He's telling the bell.
Wait a minute, I don't know what he saw.
He certainly has had a little bit of friction recently with a Perry Saturn, as Scott Dickinson. But he's called the bell, and we've had no official verdict on the outcome of this. Well, it's going to raise the hand of Jericho.
Ladies and gentlemen, your winner, Lionheart, Chris Jericho.
I didn't give up. No!
An irate Perry Saturn, who loses via disqualification.
That is an excellent professional wrestler. I don't know how he does it with the ring and the bell. 1, 2, 3.
And now I check Scott Dickerson's pocket for some extra cash.
Well, we are now, cameras have followed now, Goldberg to the police precinct closest here to the Georgia.